E aí, galera! Eu conversei com o diretor de narrativa de Far Cry 6 e até perguntei pra ele se teremos um dia Far Cry no Brasil. Então, bora lá pra entrevista! Hi, Navi! I'm Arthur from Warner Play Channel, and first of all, thank you for your time and welcome to our channel.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here. Nice to meet you.
Nice. Let's talk about Far Cry 6. What are the biggest news that a Far Cry player will identify in this game?
Well, yeah, I think the most sort of exciting part about it is, you know, they're going to be able to go to the island of Yara and sort of be thrown into a guerrilla revolution. And I think that's it'll be pretty refreshing for the brand. You're going to be able to experience a really epic journey, story that covers the entire island, while also having a really personal kind of character arc sort of within that. And then beyond that, you know, in terms of the gameplay, it's really exciting. You're going to be able to kind of embody this concept of resolver, which is making do with what you have. We were really excited about this notion of having one gorilla feel like a thousand, using anything they can find. So there's a huge range of new, what we call resolver weapons, and these Supremo backpacks that kind of even the playing field, so to speak.
And about Giancarlo Esposito, he is an amazing actor, you know. What made you choose him to play this villain?
Well, I think with Giancarlo, he has such a legacy in terms of playing villains. You know, obviously there's Gus Fring and now Moff Gideon. But, you know, especially as we sort of honed in on the character, when we realized, you know, we felt that Anton should be Afro Yaren as well. We thought he might be able to play that with sensitivity. And then when we met him, it was just an unbelievable meeting. It was 3 or 4 hours. We just talked about character and how to make Anton feel empathetic. He brought his own props. He brought his own, cigar and a ball to represent the grenade from the trailer, and just had done some extensive notes. So it was just really exciting from the get-go. He really understands the character.
And what are the different sensations that a player will experience in the game story?
Well, I think, you know, first and foremost, we wanted to make sure that you had a personal investment in the fight, right? You know, any story about revolution, it kind of felt like you needed to be local to Yara. So you're going to experience, you know, that sense of being sort of born and raised on the island, but also similarly to if you were raised like I've been living in Toronto for 19 years. You might not have as much exposure to the rest of the country, like for your entire life. So there's a sense of exploration with Danny as well as they navigate through the island. But also we wanted to capture the sort of diversity of opinions and motivations that a revolution might have. We tend to think of revolutions as this one big homogenous like group, but really it's filled with different characters and people. You know, some people are doing it to save the country for the flag, others are doing it to shoot guns, you know. So we wanted to capture this spectrum of motivation. So I think it's really exciting. I think it's gonna be a wild ride.
Tell me about weapon customization and character customization in this game.
Yeah, so what's happened, or what we've sort of done with Far Cry 6 is your progression has been tied to your gear and your weaponry. So there isn't necessarily a skill tree anymore. And so it becomes, we call it using the right tool for the right job. You know, you have all sorts of you know, mods and attachments you can put on your weapons to and gear you can put on to sort of counteract what you're experiencing on the island, whether it's specific gear that'll stop you know, you from ingesting poison from enemies, or you know, using, you know, armor piercing bullets against the sort of Kevlar that soldiers have. So we wanted to give players freedom in their play style in all sorts of ways. So if you want to play stealth, you play stealth. If you want to go loud, you go loud. And your loadout, your gear, it'll support it. So it's really kind of ultimate freedom, which is what Far Cry is all about, as you probably know.
And for you, do you prefer to play Far Cry 6 using the stealth mode or like a Rambo mode?
I'll tell you, and my team can attest to this, I always start stealth. I always do. And then within like 30 seconds, I get bored and I want to blow everything.
Yeah.
So that's the type of player I am.
And how will the multiplayer part of the game be?
Well, you're going to be able to play the game in co-op as well. So you'll be able to play the whole game co-op, and the sort of co-op player will be able to keep their sort of player progression, their gear, their loadout. So that's really exciting. And I think, you know, the co-op folks who love co-op in Far Cry will not be disappointed. It's going to be super fun.
Okay, now little questions from our subscribers, okay?
Sure.
Could the Far Cry franchise have any connection with the Watch Dogs game?
Oh, that's a great question. Yeah. I like to think of Far Cry as living in its own kind of universe, even from game to game. So, you know, we like to throw in little Easter eggs and fun little nods. And there's plenty of that in Far Cry 6. So make sure you play it with a fine-tooth comb to see any connections there might be.
Are Far Cry games set in the same universe?
Similarly, I think, you know, the beauty of Far Cry is that each one is sort of its own world, so to speak. So it doesn't mean there aren't, you know, I have my own theories that I won't share here or how I see it. But there's definitely a lot of nods that you're going to see, some fun connections. Okay. I can't tell you everything.
Yeah, I know. And the last question, is there any chance of having a history of the Far Cry game in Brazil?
Oh, that is a very good question that I'm not allowed to say anything about. I would love to see a Far Cry game in Brazil, but yeah, I can't answer that.
I know that.
Nice try.
So that's all. Thank you, Navi, for your information, and have a nice day.
Thank you for having me, this was fun.
E é isso aí, só lembrando que o jogo Far Cry 6 vai ser lançado agora, dia 7 de outubro, vai ter um monte de conteúdo aqui no Warner Play, então você pode se inscrever, porque aqui é o lugar dos acontecimentos gamer e geek do planeta, beleza? A gente se encontra então no próximo vídeo. Um abraço e tchau!
E aí, gostou do vídeo? Então se inscreva no Warner Play clicando aqui, e a gente deixou outras duas sugestões de vídeo pra você.